Thank you. I'm sure this is gonna work. NB-IoT and Cat-M1 are probably terms you've heard thrown around a lot now when you're talking about IoT. But what do those acronyms actually mean and why is it important? Well, network coverage is critically important to any IoT deployment, getting that information from your field device all the way back into your cloud infrastructure. And network providers understand this. They understand the long-term importance of these digital ecosystems and the value of the data that you're capturing. And it's so important that network providers from around the globe have realized they need to partition sections of their own network specifically for IoT. And they've called that the Cellular Low Power Wide Area Network, or LPWAN. And it does what it says on the box. It's great for low power consumption, but also wide coverage, which is perfect for remote monitoring and IoT. And what sits within this LPWAN are two global standard technologies, NB-IoT and Cat-M1. But to tell you a bit more about them and highlight some of the key features that are really important to me, I thought we'd get out of the office and grab some scientific props. Don't worry, it'll make sense. So it's a bit windier than I thought it would be, but this open space is going to be perfect. I really want to illustrate the difference in capability across the cellular network with 5G up one end, which is great for high data payloads and streaming video to your mobile device, and then NB-IoT and Cat-M1 down the other end, which have a far smaller payload, but really good for signal coverage. And I thought I'd bring these props along. And it looks a bit silly, but we've run the numbers and this should be about right. So we've got 5G here, Cat-M1 here, and then this little guy is NB-IoT. I'm going to launch these and give you a really good idea of kind of what signal penetration you can expect from each of these technologies. All right, so I hope I nail this, but NB-IoT, well, that goes right out there. Cat-M1 doesn't go as far, but still get quite a bit of coverage. Then for 5G, well, it doesn't go far at all. And for where you don't have any mobile coverage at all, you could probably leverage a satellite. Now, in reality and speaking in averages, from a regular cell tower and with the current band allocations, we're going to get about 2 to 3 kilometers of 5G coverage at 3.6 gigahertz, about 20 kilometers of Cat-M1 coverage, and then about 30 kilometers of NB-IoT coverage. What this all culminates in is that in Australia, 99.5% of our population lives within standard mobile coverage in about 2.5 million square kilometers. Cat-M1 then covers about 3 million square kilometers, and then NB-IoT covers 4, which makes it surprisingly reliable, even in extremely challenging and remote locations. So the next time you have a conversation about NB-IoT or Cat-M1, you're going to know that it's a secure part of the cellular network that's been partitioned just for IoT devices, and that it has something to do with a guy holding balls in a park.